This is Greg from FRC Foamies. I'm at the field this morning with the RC Powers SU30 version 4. Very exciting day for us SU fans because RC Powers now has two of them, the SU30 and SU34. The SU30 here is a 30-inch wingspan, and I believe the SU34 may be a 34-inch wingspan because it's a lot bigger than this one on the plan. I've done this with the setup that Dave recommended on the forum, which is the elevons and rudders, and that's it. No KF airfoils. He says keep it light. You can see these notches here in the wing. These are the center of gravity marks. Scott was talking about how they put notches in the wing for center of gravity. If you put your fingers on those notches, you can balance it out very nicely. Those would be hidden by KF2 airfoils if you choose to use those. But right now it doesn't look bad, and it's a great indication of where the CG is at all times. I'm using the Microjet version 3 on a 6x4 prop using a 1500 3S battery. I've got the ability to swap that out very quickly by using a 2S battery and the 7x3.8 wide slow fly prop. I did not want to activate the canards for this first jet, but I did want to have some dihedral because it's my personal belief that if you have a canard that's not moving, under certain angles of attack, the airflow is actually being blocked from hitting the wing. So this dihedral drives the airflow over the root of the wing and should give some good lift even at higher angles, and it's not activated, so it saves some weight and a little bit less complexity. So we'll see how that does. Very nice vertical performance with the Microjet version 3. Looks beautiful in the air. Very stable high alpha. Using the rudders to bring it around. Got to try to recover from that. Yeah, it's there's no gyros on this plane, but it really wants to hover. All right, let's go for some high alpha before the hover. All right, let's bring it in. Nice glide. Beautiful. Very well-rounded, balanced plane. It does want to do high alpha and hover. It's a matter of me practicing. Somebody like Kiko, who has the gyros on his planes, he should be able to hover this no problem, hands-off hovering. Beautiful looking plane. The control surfaces are just right. Dave and Scott made a comment on the forum about limiting the size of the control surfaces so that somebody setting up this plane does not have to dial in expo and reduced rates to get it to fly to their liking. And I've got 100% throws and zero expo on this, and it's a very smooth flyer, so I think they've done it. I think they've really done their homework on the control surfaces. I think I will add ailerons on a 2x4 mix, put the ailerons and elevons off of the one servo, and I think I will activate the canards there for the extreme high alpha, and then we should be good. So I'm going to try this on a 7-inch prop 2-cell battery. All right, so I've got the 7x3.8 wide slow fly prop on there. You can see there's plenty of room. I did widen out the prop slot just a little bit, but there's plenty of room between the stabilizers. And what I'm looking for now is for that prop to be spreading its prop wash over the control surfaces better, namely the rudders. I'd like a little bit better response from the rudders than the 3-cell 6x4 prop setup gave me. So let's see how it goes. Beautiful.